Hello, thank you for coming. Thank you for joining me on my page today. Today, we want to talk about how you, as a spouse who is a student studying abroad in Europe, can bring in your spouse, be it from Africa or from anywhere in the world, to join you. It is possible if you're a student studying to bring in your spouse. I did it and I believe you also can do it. So how is that possible? What are the steps? In this video, we're going to talk about it. And if you are interested, please click the subscribe button. And the first thing I want you to know, number one thing, as a student, you want to make sure that you're a full-time student. In Europe, you've paid your tuition fees and you have no problems with the school. Like, you have paid, you're fully enrolled and you're a full-time student. You want to make sure that it's clear. So once you are a student and everything is going on smoothly, the next thing you want to do is to try to get a job. Make sure you have a contract job where you have signed some documents, you've signed some papers and showing that you're working with that company, and maybe you have a fixed salary with them, or you know, you have something substantial coming in from this company. You want to make sure that you have a job, a steady job. It's very important. Next thing you want to do after you have a steady job is for you to have an apartment registered under your name. It is very important, especially in Estonia. There is no way you can move forward to bring in your spouse if you don't have a registered apartment under your name as a resident in Estonia. So you're a student, make sure you have an apartment registered to your name in Estonia. And once that is done, now you can move to the next step, which is documentation. Now you have an apartment registered under your name in Estonia, the next thing you want to do is to satisfy your marriage certificate. The only way you can prove that you're married to someone is by bringing in your marriage certificate. Your marriage certificate from your country, you have to certify it here in Estonia as well. First of all, you have to certify it from your own country, and then you come again. Yeah, in Estonia, they have to still put their own stamp on it. And then after they put their stamp on it, you have to still take it again to one of the ministries for them to put in the system to register you and your spouse in the system. Once that is done, then you can now move to the next stage of inviting your spouse. If you haven't done any of these steps, there is no way you can actually invite your spouse to come join you as a student. Another important thing you have to prove as a student is financial document. You want to make sure you have something in the bank, you know, you have something to your name before you can even try to invite your spouse. It's not that you must have too much, but you want to make sure you have some, you know, some couple of thousands of euros in your bank to show that, okay, I have this, you know, so I can actually take care of my family. You want to make sure that is available. So once all these things are available, the next thing for you to do is book an appointment online and go to the police and border guard in Tallinn, in Estonia, anywhere, and you apply for your spouse to join you. They will give you the steps, they will advise you accordingly, they will take you throughout the process, and if they need any more document, any further document, they will always get in touch with you and ask you to provide this and that and that and that. The process is very simple. As long as everything, you have all your documents, you know, if you have all your documents and you do it on time, the process is very simple. If you need more information how to bring in your spouse, especially if you're based in Estonia, you can actually go to police and border guard and ask them, you know, go for customer service, ask them more information how you can bring in your spouse as a student. They will always guide you. So that is how I did mine, and I brought in my spouse. So you can also do that, and you bring in your spouse. There are two ways to bring in your spouse. You can either go just directly and bring in your spouse on a permanent resident, or you can bring in your spouse for a visit. And then once your spouse is in Estonia, then you can now change from a visit to a permanent resident by going to the police and border guard and apply for a permanent resident. My own case, I brought in my spouse directly with a permanent resident. So what we did was that my spouse was based in Dubai, so he just went to the nearest Estonian embassy and did not apply for a D visa. He just applied for a permanent resident to come join his spouse, and waited. After he applied, he went back and waited for about 1.5 to 2 months, and he got a call that his documents were ready. Before actually getting the document, his final, his permanent resident, sometimes we got a call and or emails from the police and border guard or from the person who was actually filling our papers, asking us to add some documents or guiding us accordingly. So that's why I'm telling you, once you start the process, they will always guide you accordingly because that happened to us. Your spouse can apply for a visit visa to come visit you. That is a D visa, I guess, or a C visa. But once your spouse is in Estonia, you now take your spouse, as I said, to the police and border guard and now convert it to a permanent resident. So that is how I brought my spouse. If you're thinking of bringing in your spouse anywhere in Europe, you just need to go and get information from the people who are in charge of these things and they will guide you accordingly. In Estonia, it's police and border guard. They will always guide you accordingly. You can actually go to their website or you actually take an appointment and just go to their customer service and get more information. So please, if you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. If you're thinking of bringing in your spouse or your kids, come on, you can do it. It's not difficult. All you need to do is get information about it, start the process, and keep going. See you some other time on this channel. If you haven't subscribed again, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.